Hi there. Today I'm here for Whippin' Up Wednesday Crock-Pot Dish. It's a collaboration from some special ladies that have invited us to join in. Linda from Linda's Pantry, Mandy from More to Life, Lisa from Sutton's Days, Heather from The Needy Homesteader, and Tina from Wilhelm's Kitchen. And today, I'm going to make something for you that my husband loves. I know he will eat this from the crock pot. It's a meatball potato mushroom stew. When I was sick many years ago, in fact, I was after I had one of my children, a dear sweet sister neighbor brought this for us, and we loved it and have loved it ever since. So I thought I'd bring you all along and show you how to make it. It's very easy. I had some mushrooms in my fridge that were getting to the point they have to be used. So I sliced them up and threw them in the crock pot. And I made a video of meatballs and put them in my freezer. They're just like the meatballs you can buy in the store that are already prepackaged, except these are homemade, which I think tastes so much better. They taste better, they are more healthy, they don't have all the garbage in them that the store-bought ones do. And so I have a video on this, and I will put the link below if I can figure out how. If you don't see it below in the with the description of the video, go to the first comment, because I know how to link it in the comment. And so I'll put the video of how to make these meatballs. They just are delicious. They'll make this stew really, really good. Then I've peeled up some potatoes. Now when you do your potatoes, these are Yukon Gold, but you can really use any kind of potato you want. These I washed them really good, and just cut them into big chunks. This is a stew that's just got great big chunks of potatoes. The only thing that goes in it is potatoes and meatballs. And I had those mushrooms, and I knew they would be really good in this too. Now the original recipe calls for some cream soup, cream of mushroom soup. But I'm not a fan of cream of mushroom soup. And I really don't buy it much. I actually don't have any on hand. So I'm doing this just a little bit different. I'm going to put some broth in. This is just chicken broth. You can buy some, you can make some. If you have homemade, canned, that's all the better. And the broth is optional. You could use beef broth or onion broth or whatever kind of broth you have. These meatballs have onions in them. So this is really a versatile recipe. And then I just have some salt and pepper here that I'm going to put on top of my potatoes and everything. And I put this on, it's, 11 o'clock in the morning. I've set this on high because we have a play to go to tonight for our granddaughters. They're going to be in Anne of Green Gables, and we're so excited to go watch them. But we want to have this before we go. So we've put this in the crock pot. I want it to cook on high. If it gets done sooner than 4 hours, then that's great. We'll just put it on warm and eat it when the time comes. I'm going to cook it down until these potatoes are tender and the meatballs are cooked through, and then I'll show you what we're going to do next to this, okay? So I'll just be back in a little bit. Okay, I've cooked this for 4 hours. I think 3 would have been enough as I'm looking at it. It's a little bit soft, but it looks good. I've made a slurry with some cornstarch and some milk. I just took about a cup of milk with a couple of tablespoons of cornstarch. I'm going to pour it right in. This is going to heat up and make a thickened gravy. This is going to get all hot and bubbly and thicken up, and then it will be ready to eat. Okay, I've added the slurry of cornstarch, and this is all thick and ready to eat. So let me spoon up a little bit and show you how delicious it is. It's not time to eat right now, but I will give you a taste test. See how thick and yummy that gravy is on top of the potatoes and the meatballs. It really is very delicious. An easy meal. I wanted to mention, you don't have to use homemade meatballs. You can buy the meatballs in the store. Also, you can use cream of chicken soup, or cream of mushroom, or any cream soups you have if you like, instead of making your soup like I did. I used one can of chicken broth in this to cook it in, and then after it was done, I thickened it with 1 cup of milk with 2 tablespoons of cornstarch in it to make my gravy. But you can do it either way, whatever is easiest for you. I used 20 meatballs that are about the size of a quarter. I used 8 Yukon Gold potatoes, and I used 1 can of cream of chicken soup and some salt and pepper. And I used about 1 cup of mushrooms. Then I thickened it with 1 cup of milk, thickened with 2 tablespoons of cornstarch. And I did that at the very end to thicken up the food. Now let me find a spoon. Just a minute. Okay, let me taste this for you. A little bit of meatball, a little bit of potato, and a little bit of gravy. This is a really delicious dish that's so easy to make, very hearty, and everybody that I know that's tried it really enjoys it. So let me see what it tastes like. Delicious. Tastes like meatballs and potato. I would put a little bit of salt and pepper on this, and it's really good. So I hope you enjoy Whip It Up Wednesday crock pot meatballs and potato stew. Yummy. I'll see you next week.